Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Thank you for tuning back in. Today I have with me once again Maitreyi Shrestha from the Maitri Bodh Parivar. If you haven't watched our previous videos yet, please do check them out. We've done two videos together, one about Maitri Light and Maitri Bodh Parivar, and of course Dada Shri Ji, and then one about spiritual transformation. Once again, Maitri Shrestha, warm welcome, and thank you for taking time out to be with me on my channel today.
Namaste, Pooja. Thank you so much for having me again. Thank you.
Wonderful. Today, we are going to talk about prayer, and Maitri Shrestha will share with us what prayer means, the importance of prayer, and how we can put across our prayer or live in prayer. Over to you, Maitri Shrestha.
Thank you, Pooja. So, from the time, if you see in all of our cultures, in every religion, I would say, there is a practice to pray. It's one thing which is common in every religion because it is a way to connect with the divine. So, if you see Christianity, Islam, Hinduism, in absolutely every religion that is there is a way to pray. Or a place to go to pray to, or pray from home. And everybody, all children, they have prayers in school in their own way. Children are taught to pray right from the time we are born, we are growing up, we've been asked to pray. But the thing is that for all of us, and at least in my personal experience, when I was growing up, my parents said that, I followed what they did. And they would stand in front of the shrine just before they left for their day, and they would say their prayers, they would say a couple of mantras, and they would say it and just leave. And when we would pray, when my brother and I, we would stand in front of our shrine and we would pray, we would do the exact same thing. So that's it, that was it. And then when you have your exam, then you do something, examination or an interview, then you have to do something extra, then there's an extra additional prayer, then there's a little bribe which also goes to the divine. With some nice mithai or something like that. And so this is how we've grown up. Now, this is about the Hindu culture, but in every culture, I'm sure there is this, practice of different ways in which they pray. But it has just been coming down like that. It has just been coming down that, it is something you have to stand in front of the divine, you have to say these chants or say these particular mantras, and then you have to kind of go on with your day. But after I met Dada, he made it more personal. He said that a prayer is not a formal conversation. It is not a give and take with the divine. The divine is not your business partner, where you make a deal with him. Or the divine is not just somebody, you in your building or in your house when you wake up in the morning and you leave for the day and you just say hi, hello, and walk past. So he says that's not the relationship that one should have with the divine. The relationship that you need to have with the divine is the most personal one, the one that you would have with your parents or your spouse or your children, and closer than that. And that is because the divine knows you more than your parents or your siblings or the people who you consider to be closest. In fact, your divine knows you more than even what you know yourself. Because the divinity that you follow, and that divine is complete one, the source is one, that source knows you not just for this lifetime, but for so many lifetimes. And so the divine knows exactly what you need, when you need, why you have come back, why you've come to this planet, why you've been born, what are your learnings, what are your karmas, all of these things the divine knows. And that's why the divine accepts you the way you are. So however you are, whoever you are, whether you judge yourself, the divine never judges you because the divine knows why we are exactly the way we are. And
Beautiful.
so Yeah, and so he says that, make it personal. Make it personal to the divine. Talk to the divine, express yourself to the divine. Let prayer become that conversation with the divine, which is the most meaningful conversation you have, which is the conversation about yourself. So when you stand, when you pray in front of the divine, let your heart be there, let your consciousness be there, be completely present. and talk to the divine, express to the divine. And if you don't know the words to express, then we will help you with words, like how we will be doing a prayer at the end of the session today. So then we will help you with the best possible words. But a prayer is an expression. Just express to your divine freely. Tell your divine whatever you want, anything that you need. That is a prayer, spending quality time and expressing to the divine. So even if you don't know a particular mantra, but you just want to stand in front of the divine and express, that is also a prayer. And a prayer is very, very important that we make it a daily habit, a daily practice, because it should be an integral part. Just like the way we speak to all our friends and family, we do our work. In that way, a prayer is a very positive expression that one must incorporate in whatever form in their daily life. Mm. Start with 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes. And then gradually, a prayer becomes a part of your being. So then you're in the state of prayer, which is, if you go on with that prayer, with the practice of prayer, it becomes a part of your being. So then you're in a state of prayer. And then constantly there is an interaction which is happening from within. So this is a little bit about, prayer and why we should pray. So, yeah.
That's beautiful. And so beautifully explained that it's a conversation, because there is a lot of it's an interesting topic, because there's a lot of confusion around this. Okay, if I pray, does it mean that I am associating with a certain religion, or how do I pray, or what should I say, when should I say? These questions do come up when we talk about prayer sometimes. And you said it so beautifully. It's a deliberate conversation. And it is another word that I have heard and that I like a lot. It's energizing. So it's an exchange, but it's energizing. It's like, it reminds me of something that we did as kids in school. I'm sure you've done it too, taking a magnifying glass and then harnessing the light of the sun, the energy of the sun, and then burning paper, or, what we learned at school anyway, we've done that. So I feel like, living in a state of prayer, like you said, it's not something we do once in a day. It's living, being in a state of prayer is like fueling that fire and setting that light around us. That's what I feel like it is. It's energizing. So thank you for sharing that. Now, moving on, like you said, we will be saying out a prayer together. And we're going to say a prayer that is called the Mother Earth prayer, and that has been taught by Dada Shriji. Can you, before we say the prayer, can you tell us a little more about this prayer in particular?
Yeah, sure. So when we started the topic, we were talking about prayers for yourself, when you pray for yourself. But a prayer in itself is very, very powerful to actually move things. We take prayers for granted. Most often think that, oh, it's just a prayer. We can't see the results. You actually can see the results if you are, if you just go within, you can actually see the results manifesting. Usually we pray for things which are most often material. We never usually ask the divine to help us learn our lessons, to make us a better human being. It's like, I want a bigger house. I want a better car. I want a good job. So it's most often these things, which is also fine. I'm not saying that you shouldn't, but also one should ask for things which are for your internal growth.
Yes.
And sometimes I think it's best to leave it to the divine to kind of decide what is best for you. Because like I said, the divine is like a mother. A mother actually knows best what is best for the child. The way a mother will scold you, the way a mother will love you, the way a mom is with her baby is exactly what the divine is for us. So sometimes it's best to leave it to the divine also, that give me whatever you feel. So pray for what you want. At the end of it, leave it to the divine. And prayers have immense power and immense potential. So when you pray, your prayers are being heard. So if you address your prayer to your divine, it is important to address the prayer to your divine. So mm-hmm. once you address it, once you call upon the divine, and once you address your prayer to the divine, be rest assured that it is being heard. Mm-hmm. You know, we pray now and in 5 minutes we want results, but it takes time. It takes time in our entire life chart for the divine. If we ask something which is not for the purpose of our life, you know, it's something else, if we are deviated, there needs to be a lot of things which have to be changed. And then that prayer manifests. So we have to give it time, but be rest assured that each and every prayer that we say is heard.
Yes.
About personal prayers, and then prayers for others, like prayers for humanity, prayers for Mother Earth. These are also prayers which are very, very important. And when more we do it, or, you know, if there are more people doing it, or the more we do these kind of prayers. So a personal prayer, you need not repeat after you've expressed it. But prayers like these, the Mother Earth prayer, or if you go to the Maitri Bodh website, there are 4 to 5 prayers which are mentioned. There is the Grace Prayer, the Universal Prayer, Mother Earth Prayer, Prayer for Humanity. So there are these couple of prayers which are mentioned. So these are prayers for everybody else, which includes us,
right?
Also as humanity. So Mother Earth prayer, basically Dada Shri Ji says that Mother Earth is not like, you know, we look at her as an inanimate. So many of us, you know, the perception is that it's a planet. What we've been taught in school is that it's a planet. It rotates and revolves, you know, around the sun. And that's about it. But she's more than that, because she gives life.
Yes.
So if something is inanimate, that cannot create life on its own. So she's completely alive. She's completely active, and she has a heart, and she expresses herself. And in the current time, Mother Earth has expressed herself very explicitly about what she wants or what she needs. And she's, you know, she's tolerated, and she's like, taken on all the pain for so many years. You know how a mother would do that? No, my children will become better. They'll become better. Let me give them more time. In the same way, she has taken on all that pain for so many years, so many years. And today the time has come where all of us are trying. You know, there are so many families and youth who are changing their lifestyles. You know, people who are turning to minimalism, veganism. Yes. And the reason is not for, majority of the times, it is not just for my individual health, but it is also so that we save our planet. So that you know, conscious living is a concept which is naturally coming from within. And that means that you're, you know, getting aligned with what Mother Earth needs. So if this is happening with anybody who's watching this video, you're already in alignment with what Mother Earth needs. So these are practical measures, you know, these are practical measures which all of us are taking to help Mother Earth. But there is something more which needs to be done. And there's a very beautiful, simple example, Pooja, which I'd like to share, which Dada has only shared. So we call him Dada lovingly. Dada Shri Ji, we say Dada. So Dada shared this beautiful example. He said that, you know, if when you were a child and when you got hurt, you know, let's say you fell and you got hurt and you started bleeding, what's the next thing? You know, you go to the doctor puts a bandage around you. So this is a practical measure. But what is it that feels really good? You know, when your mom, she hugs you and she takes you close and she gives you love. So yes, a practical healing is required, you know, a physical healing. But that feeling of being loved, that feeling of someone really cares about you. And when our mom, she'll hug you and she'll say that you will be fine, and that's it. The pain just vanishes. It's just gone. And that's the power of love. And this prayer, this Mother Earth prayer, because our mother is now hurt. So we as her children, all of us together, need to express our love to her. So live a conscious life. So practical measures, taking your medicine, putting your bandage, or putting a bandage on Mother Earth. Yes, that's great. And we must continue to do that. Along with that, side by side, express your love to Mother Earth from time to time. That she feels it. And you'll experience it today while doing this, you'll experience that she connects, she communicates, she connects with you. You'll actually experience that happening if you go deep within and, you know, just simply connect to God. So, yeah, that's why the Mother Earth prayer. It is a prayer to express to Mother Earth that I love you. I promise to take care of you. I will do better. And just know that I do love you and I care for you a lot. That's what it is.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Can't wait to do the prayer with you now. All right. Guide us through it, please.
Sure. Great. Okay. So wherever you are and wherever the viewers are sitting, all you have to do is you have to place your palms on the ground below you. So just place your palms on the ground below you, or if you're sitting on a chair, you can just place your hand on your chest and you can visualize Mother Earth in your heart. Okay. Mm-hmm. So while you are, you know, while you have placed your hands on the ground, completely try to feel Mother Earth. So close your eyes and just feel her. Just connect with her as you would connect with your mother. Bring that love in your heart, thinking about all the things Mother Earth has done for us until now. Completely awaken that feeling within you. Just visualize that you're experiencing Mother Earth. And now with all the love in your heart, touching Mother Earth, let us express this prayer. So I will say the first line and you may repeat after me. Today and now.
Today and now.
I express my love and care for you.
I express my love and care for you.
Forgive me for causing pain to you.
Forgive me for causing pain to you.
Let me protect and nurture you once again.
Let me protect and nurture you once again.
Let me heal your wounds with my love.
Let me heal your wounds with my love.
Love, love, and only love for you.
Love, love, and only love for you.
Now from your heart and through your hands, just give love to Mother Earth. You may express your gratitude to her, say thank you. And then you may gently lift your hands and slowly open your eyes.
Beautiful. Thank you very much.
Simple. It's really simple. It's just 5 minutes, just positive words, but yes. It's very impactful. It's very, very impactful. And she feels it.
Yeah, very much. Like you said, she's very much alive. And there's so much wisdom out there. And just by connecting with nature, we're tuning in, we're getting more aligned to that higher wisdom, to that wisdom that is all encompassing, right? It's all around us. And that higher consciousness. So aligning with that is truly magical, right? It's what everybody should aim for and strive for. So that's a wonderful way to start. If anybody is wondering how to start a prayer or how to live in a state of prayer, start with what feels simple. Maybe just connect to something that you can see, like nature, like Mother Earth. So I think this is such a great way to start, such a simple and something that will feel that can feel very organic to anyone who wants to start this journey. So thank you. Thank you very much for sharing this. And thank you for sharing all that you've shared with us so far. And thank you once again, Maitri Shrestha, for being here. And thank you to all the viewers for spending some time to watch this. And I do hope that you implement this in your life. Let us know if you have any questions and feel free to reach out if you need any guidance or help. Thank you and goodbye. See you again very soon.